just walked out in front of my car. Thank God I was going slowly.
What was that? Oh, bleeding women drivers. Oh,
sexist.
Cheer up, love. We're only joking.
Oh, no, it's OK, madam. We've identified the main problem.
What is it?
You've run him over.
In my face. Oh, shit, right, better get the old jump leads out. Oh, can I just test these for
Oh, right, madam, I'm going to have to ask you to stand back.
Are you going to give him an electric shock?
No, I've just farted.
Please just stop.
Says you. If you'd done that, I don't think we'd be here right now.
Come on, let's pull him round. One, two, three, clear. One, two, three, clear. Hey, I need a shot of adrenaline out there now.
Wait till after. We got work to do.
Are you serious? Stop dicking about.
All right, mate. Sorry.
Ah, had you.
Oh, you total git.
High five.
He's dead. Oh, God, he's dead.
He's dead. Oh, God, he's dead.
Oh, shit. He really is dead. How big's your boot?
Excuse me. Hi. I'm looking for Reuben's three graces.
Reuben's, eh? She's over here. No.
Oh, thank you.
Reuben!
Yes, it's lovely.
Fantastic painting. Wow.
It's three women, naked, dancing a bit, holding hands. I don't know why. It's a mystery. Lesbian? I don't think so. It's 17th century. They don't have lesbian.
They're sisters from mythology.
And they are fat. Very, very fat. Don't get me wrong. I love it. Three fat women.
And they look so real.
If you look at it from the side, as I have,
it's totally flat.
But if you look at it from the front, pow, boom.
Fatty, fatty, boom.
I also recommend very highly Madonna by Leonardo da Vinci. She have one booby, bleep, out. It's very, very small, but very, very nice. You know it. Carry on.
All right, before I recommend a treatment, I just need to go through a few questions.
All right.
Do you suffer from dryness?
No.
Have you got a T-zone? What's with the acne? Is it in hereditary?
I don't have...
Do you have a routine? Have you got paper on your face? Does it go see-through? When you look in the mirror, what do you see? Is it this? Or is it this? Oh! Can I do a patch test? Oh. If the eyes are the window to the cell, what's your mouth? Is it a back coral? Nice! Have you ever known true love?
If I lay here, if I just lay here, would you lie with me and just forget the world?
Complexion, I'd recommend the Dermaplas Hydroxy Facial, $45.99 plus VAT.
What ho, darling, look here. I've got 2 days shore leave. Let's have a party. I shall have Dawkins fish to grow off with her at once.
Not now, darling.
Party just the thing. Get us into the spirit for socking it to Fritz.
Darling, now really isn't the time.
Ha ha! Take that, Jelly. Kaboom!
Won't you stop that frightful noise, Pongo?
Oh, it wasn't war wonderful. I've made so many new friends in the Navy. Tempo, Enders, Crump, even some of those dreadful Americans. I shall invite them all to the party.
Pongo, darling, there's something you should know. It's Freddy.
Oh, Freddy, I do hope you like my new chums. I shall telephone him at once. Hello? 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 Freddy's not there. How queer.
That's just it. He's not queer. Not anymore. He's dead. Freddy's dead and Lulu's dead. Done for by a doodlebug at the Café de Paris. I should have been there, but I took a wrong turn at the Trocadero.
A party's just a thing. It'll be like old times.
Oh, it's hopeless, Pongo. This beastly war. Soon we shall all be dead. You, me, Tempo, Enders, Crump, even some of those dreadful Americans.
That's a spirit, Margot. I shall have Dawkins fetch the bunting from the attic, the crewel from the cellar, and Freddy's ashes from the crematorium to keep beneath my bunk.
Damn the Nazis and damn their jackboots and lederhosen and naked sunbathing. One day they shall stop the killing and let all the gay lords and lesbons alone.
Family and friends, I guess I started drinking from boredom and sense of isolation, but then it spiralled out of control.
Hell, my car's broken down. Has anyone got a tow truck? This is the AA, isn't it?
No, it's just group therapy, Mike. Like I tell you every week.
Oh, right, yes, yes, of course, for people with problems.
This week, we're concentrating on emotional crutches. That's drink, drugs, food. Yes, John?
Well, I've been thinking that my shyness could have been the root of my problem. I took drugs because I was shy, and I got to the stage that that was the only way I could feel normal.
Sounds to me like you just need to get interesting, John.
Thank you, Mike, for that.
Oh, that's a pleasure, Lucy.
My name's Laura.
Of course it is.
Well done, John. Harriet, if it's okay with you, let's go back to the subject of your husband's affair and your crutch at that time.
I can't imagine it got much use, to be honest.
I was reluctant to admit it was the cause of all my problems, and if I faced it, it would mean it was actually happening. Drinking numbed my feelings of worthlessness.
Well, your husband certainly isn't, is he? Oh, come on. Chillax. Have a drink.
I'm an alcoholic.
Mike, you really can't say these things.
Well, whoops, get me a time machine, cos it's too late. I already have Laura.
Laura. My name's bloody Laura.
Sounds to me like someone needs a bit of anger management, eh, John?
Right. Well. Job done, I think. Anyone off for the pub? No? Pint of crutch before we head off to Beachy Head? No? All right. Suit yourselves. See ya. Wouldn't want to be ya.
Splendid party, what?
Wonderful. Pongo.
Freddy.
Lulu.
Freddy. Pongo.
Lulu!
Margot!
Pongo!
Freddy!
Lulu!
Freddy!
Pongo!
Lulu!
Margot!
Oh, Pongo! The phantasms of our dead lovers!
Everything!
Darling, could you hold my glass?
Of course.
Thank you.
Silly little poof.
What?
Trick or treatment. Come on, love, it makes it all fun.
Come through.
Oh, thank God. Ow. Nasty.
Yeah, it's gonna have to come off.
I need some brandy, some hot towels, and a great big carving knife.
Really?
For God's sake, just get on with it.
Of course, madam. Right, so may I ask if this is your good hand?
Yes.
Wrong. It's clearly your fucked hand. Which will never be the same again.
This is ridiculous.
Well, sir, can you talk me through exactly what happened?
I was getting some books up there. I fell, put my hand down, and there was an almighty crack.
So you broke your wrist while looking through the top shelf publications? I wonder what you were doing.
Are you going to help my husband or not?
Sir, can you move your fingers?
I think so.
Right, what I need you to do is try and grab hold of my finger. Oh, I love working with you.
Oh, what a team. What a crack team. My first, my last, my everything. And the answer to all my dreams. You're my son, my moon, my God.
You like this?
Yes, it's
Bronzino, Venus and Cupid. Venus, the goddess of love, and this is her son, Eros.
So why he touch her boobie like that? I don't know, cheeky baby.
To be honest, I don't like it. I mean, mother and child, I mean, come on, it's bloody weird.
Do you know who the others are?
This one's an old man. And this one's a cherub. This one's definitely a woman. And this one's a little bit pissed off about something, but I don't know why. As I said, I don't like it. I mean, Venus, she's all right. I wouldn't say no. But this hand on the boob, ugh. You know it. Carry on.
That's right, yeah. Rub it in.
How's the Asbo?
Oh, lovely, thanks, yeah.
So how does it work again? If you shout at a woman out of a van, you'll...
go to prison.
But you love shouting at women out of a van.
Yes, I'm aware of that.
You do it all the time.
It's broken Britain, Dave, broken Britain.
Can I still shout at women out of a van?
Yeah, to your heart's content.
But if you do it...
prison.
Do you know, mate? You can still shout at blokes.
I don't shout at blokes, Dave.
Yeah, you do.
Last Saturday night, you shouted at that man outside the club.
No, I never.
Yes, you did.
You shouted at that man, and then you cried and told me about Colin.
No, I never. I didn't. I like birds.
You're not allowed to shout.
I can shout at you.
See? You do shout at blokes.
Counsel for the prosecution, you may examine the witness.
All right, I just need to go through a few questions.
OK.
Do you know the defendant?
No.
Were you present at the scene of the crime?
Yes,
I... What did you say? Was it a murder? Oh, Danny. Was his head stuffed in? Was he gout? Did he look like this? What happens when we die? Do we go to heaven? What if we've been bad? Have you been bad? Have you been a naughty boy? Did you eat your greens? Am I going to have to give you a smack?
This really will not...
Who asked you? That's just a big guy with my eyes. Are you looking at me funny? Are you looking at me funny or what? Did he done it?
What?
Did he done the murder? Was it you?
No.
Are you saying I'm an idiot? It's a law in house. Are you stouting on me? Are you stouting on me because I could have you? Do you believe in love at first sight?
What?
Do you believe in love at first sight? Or do I have to walk past again? No more questions, my love.
I've discovered meditation really focuses my mind, so I think less about drinking, and that's really helping.
Great. Really great. I think that deserves a clap.
One for a little one. Me, of course, not that.
Well, thanks for joining us eventually.
Oh, and a pleasure to see you again, Marlene.
My name's Laura. OK.
Has anyone else had any successes recently? Yes.
Well, I'm really dealing with my brother's death and I haven't felt depressed in a good 2 months. So.
Anyone else? Yes, go ahead, Veronique.
Yes, thanks to these sessions, I've been able to tackle my compulsive need to turn lights on and off and my need to clean obsessively.
Not the need to eat cake, I see.
Sometimes leaving the house would take me hours and hours because I'd have to check the locks over and over, and although I'm dealing with it, I still find it hard, you know? Sometimes I think, why can't I be normal? Have a normal life like everyone else.
Mike, what are you doing?
Oh, I'm playing a tiny little violin for Veronique.
Mike, this is not on.
Or is it on, Veronique? Or is it off? Or is it on? Or is it off? Or is it on? Off, on. Who knows? But let's check 482 times. And that way, Veronique, our family won't die in a car crash.
Are you mocking Veronique's problems?
Oh, lighten up, people. Come on, get it? All a bit mental here. All a few biscuits short of a packet, a few pigeons short of a pie.
You bloody stop that, you bloody mentalist.
Scared of the dark?
I'm as drunk as a lord. Look here, darling. Now that the war's over and everybody's dead, I thought we could start again.
Oh, we can't, Ponga. You've changed, I've changed. You're smaller than I remember.
We'll be just like old times.
There isn't a thing to sit on.
That's just it. We're stony broke, Ponga. The war's cleaned us right out.
I'll have the staff spruce up the house right away.
It's no use. The bank's taken the house and all the staff have emigrated. There's Cook, of course, but she's dead.
Isn't rationing thrilling?
I've taken a job as a bus conductor. It's terribly working class. I shall probably have to wear flat shoes and eat suet.
Very good, darling. More shampoo.
And I'm leaving you, Pongo.
Oh, dear. Margot, you're wearing trousers.
Yes. Yes, I am.
Well, how long has it been going on?
Since forever. Since the day we were married.
Are you trying to tell me?
Yes. I'm a lesbian.
I was in good effect for a minute there. I thought you were communist.
Oh, Lord, no.
Well, chin-chin, darling, good luck with that. You know I've always loved you, in my own way.
Yes, but it was the back way, Pongo.
Is that why we never had children?
My name is Pablo. I am from Argentina. Would you like to dance?
I think I would.
Why would you look at that? They've taken the curtains down. I'm so free and gay and so terribly, terribly happy.
Pablo, you say? Jolly good.
That last unintelligible scream, how did she react?
Oh, completely ignored you. Another really good sign.
Really?
Yeah. Well, the best ones ignore us. You know, you're really onto something when they pay you no attention whatsoever.
Excuse me, sorry to bother you. I was just wondering if you knew where Comstock Road is. It's somewhere around here. Comstock Road? By the swimming pool. Comstock Road? Any ideas?
Say something.
I'll ask at the off license.
Think she liked me?
That was when I realised life was worth living after all.
Hello, Mike. Everything okay? Well, I'm sure you'll tell us in your own way.
I've seen shit.
Not again. I spoke to the caretaker about this. Where was it this time?
Not literal shit, metaphorical shit. Like, I know you all think I'm the entertainer in the group or something, but I don't want you thinking I haven't seen shit, because I have.
What have you seen, Mike? Talk us through it.
Well, I was on my way to work, and I passed the dog's home and I peered in as usual. And there they were, all the little chaps, running around, looking for a new home. And that's when I saw him.
Saw who?
Dave, he'd been knocked down.
Oh, Mike, you witnessed an accident.
No, Dave is a dog. But he'd been knocked down. And he'd lost his back legs. And instead of his back legs, he had wheels.
We've got abuse, alcoholism, suicidal thoughts. And now Mike, who's seen a dog with wheels for legs.
Made me realise how fragile we all are. You are. I mean, you're all dogs who've lost your back legs and you come here and you can run again. It made me realise that this group is my wheels.
That's one of the most beautiful things I think I've ever heard. We are wheels.
I'm so glad I found you. I'm not gonna let you. Whatever it takes, I will stay here with you. Take it to the good times. See it through the bad times. Whatever it takes is what I'm gonna do.
Let them say we're crazy. What do they know? Put your arms around me, baby, don't ever let go. Let the world around us just fall apart. Maybe we can make it if we're heart to heart. And we can build this dream together. Standing strong forever, nothing's gonna stop us now. And if this world burns out of love, we'll still have each other. Nothing's gonna stop us. Nothing's gonna stop us. Ooh, all that I need is you. All that I ever need. Oh.
Treacle!